At the end of the day, you might not like your job, but you like working.
Yeah.
Because you got to work. And the new jobs report shows hiring, unfortunately, actually hit a snag in December. Just 74,000 jobs added to payrolls last month.
And that's the slowest growth we've seen in 3 years. And it sent the Dow lower yesterday. Allison Kosick has more on the headlines from Wall Street. Allison, good morning.
To you.
All right, Allison, thanks. Don't know if I've actually ever had Velveeta.
I bet you've had it and you don't know you've had it. That's my theory.
Where is it hidden?
Queso. In some queso, as I understand.
Maybe. I've had it a queso at restaurants, but never at home.
I don't know if that's it.
Maybe I'll try.
I'm gonna make him some, and he won't know it.
I hear it's liquid gold.
All right, contrary to reports on the internet, by the way, Niagara Falls did not freeze solid during the week's polar vortex.
No, but it was cold enough to feel like it could.
Oh, yeah. Jennifer Gray, thank you so much.
Still to come on New Day. It is not often that you see LeBron James lose his cool. Picks the perfect music because the lyrics to that are "Tonight is the night. We're gonna fight till it's over."
Yeah.
And tonight's a big night.
It is. Seahawks, Saints. I mean, playoff football. Who doesn't love playoff football? You guys talked about the crowd noise. To get back to that, you're talking about deafening crowd noise. So this week, the Saints sort of used some interesting tactics, I should say, to get ready for that really, really loud crowd noise.
Yeah, because
coming
how do
from
you do
Seattle.
That?
Well, you use speakers, you use giant speakers, and you pump in, crowd noise through the speakers. That's what they do. It's the NFL. Mm-hmm. Yeah, should be
a good show.
All right, good
Joe Carter. Thank you.
Joe.
Thank you. So this morning, thousands of pages of documents released in the investigation into New Jersey bridge scandal and more information on who in Governor Christie's inner circle knew what was going on.
Well, Victor, let's go ahead and start in France, shall we? A brewing scandal there with French president who's considering legal action against a magazine that accused him of having a salacious affair with an actress. CNN's Jim Bitterman is there in Paris. Jim?
Christie, the French president, certainly.
It's become a show in itself at the Golden Globes.
Yeah, two stars, though. You know who's going to steal this show.
Absolutely.
It's Tina Fey and Amy Poehler. Come
Hilarious.
On, people. The comedy duo is set to host the awards for the second year in a row, which makes you think, what can they do better?
And if this year is anything like the last, viewers can expect a lot of laughs. CNN Entertainment correspondent Nichelle Turner has more. Hey, Nichelle. Well, football may be considered America's game.
Mm-hmm.
Many fans consider that to be the game of the country. But one fan is suing the NFL because he says the average fan cannot afford to go to the Super Bowl.
I bet a lot of people are agreeing with him.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, his name's Josh Finkelman, and he apparently paid $4,000. Yes, $4,000.
Sure.
All right, John Berman, thank you. And, there are some people who are still concerned that the regular season games are so expensive.
It's hard for anybody to just go, especially if you get 2, 3, 4 tickets. You want to take the family?
Yeah. We'll see if anything changes.
Yeah.
Hey, still to come on New Day, you just never know. New this morning, Neiman Marcus might be the latest retailer to be hit by hackers. The upscale store is alone when it comes to cyber hackers. We talked about the breach at Target.
Oh, boy.
Well, on Friday, Target announced that last month's security breach was a lot bigger than the company initially reported. Instead of 40 million people being affected, it actually affected about 70 million customers.
Well, not only did that number go up, but this got worse, too, because not only did they steal... A little dark and foggy in New York right now.
Yeah, all the shots from New York are a little dark and foggy right now. You call it a jammer day.
I call it a jammer day.
Stay in your jammers. Hey, new this morning, Neiman Marcus might be the latest retailer to be hit by hackers. Yes, the ups Neiman Marcus, right? Target is now saying last month's security breach was a lot bigger than the company initially reported. Not 40 million people affected, 70 million customers.
And the thing is, it's not just credit cards and debit cards that were stolen, and debit card PIN numbers, we should point out, too. CNN tech correspondent Lori Siegel has the latest on some more of your information that was compromised. Hi, Lori. Victor.
All right, Lori Siegel, thanks for the information. On New Day, Congress members may be rich beyond your wildest... 22 after the hour now, and if you think America has a do-nothing Congress, well, like it or not, there is one thing they can do.
Mm-hmm.
Become millionaires.
Mm-hmm. According to a new report, right? White House is wading into Utah's battle over same-sex marriage.
This week, Attorney General Eric Holder said the federal government will recognize marriages briefly performed in Utah, even if the state won't.
CNN's Athena Jones covering the administration's decision right now. Good morning, Athena. All righty, Athena Jones, thank you so much.
We've got more on the breaking news, the death of former Israeli Prime Minister Ariel Sharon throughout the morning. We're going to go live to Jerusalem.
First, though, Christine Romans has a preview of Your Money that's coming up in an hour from now. Good morning, Christine.
All right, welcome back. 36 minutes after the hour. Let's talk some entertainment in the E-block this morning.
Okay, pop the champagne or, you know, whatever your drink of choice is. Awards season in full swing, and tomorrow, some of Hollywood's biggest names line in the red carpet for the annual Golden Globe Awards.
Indeed. Here to talk about this year's pick, still to come on New Day, blurring the lines between cool.
All right, time for our weekly segment, Tech is Ruining My Life. Looking at the good, the bad, the ugly technology.
We begin with a new messaging app that could protect your privacy, but also save cheating spouses. Ceciliano joins us now. All right, so what should we make of an app like this? I mean, one, where did this come from? Why do we have one now?
Well, facial recognition.
Okay. You thought it was creepy. I thought it was cool until I learned more about the contact information available. Is it possible someone can just see you, maybe see a few trinkets you have on, snap a photo of you, and find out your address and then head to your home?
Well, that is possible with facial.
We're gonna come to expect, because part of me thinks, I don't know what to tell my kids.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, well, this is the norm, and it is the responsibility of the individual to manage their own.
But when I think about this app and Google Glass, that if I'm wearing the glasses, yeah, I can just wink and save a person for later and then decide what I want to do with it once I get home. I mean, can these two types of technology work together?
So, yes.
Online security expert. Thank you so much. The idea that I could, with Google Glasses,
yeah,
wink at someone, and that could be a flirt, and then also have their phone number once I want to use it.
He makes a great point. It really does force us to be more disciplined about watching what's out there online,
yeah,
about ourselves.
We've got to be careful.
So a Hollywood actress shares the secret behind. So I'll let you know this morning that we're getting some new insight into the investigation on the intentional manufactured traffic jam on the world's busiest bridge.
More than 2,000 documents have been released by. The top of the hour, 10 Eastern. A transgender teen girl fights back against classmates who bullied her for years.
Yeah, the school actually punished everyone involved in the fight, but the DA chose to file charges against the transgendered teen. Were they just prosecuting a crime, or is it a case of bias?
Yeah, we'll talk about that one. It's got a lot of different angles.
Mm-hmm. All right. I'm going to come at you next.
Big game in New England today as the Patriots host the Colts in the NFL playoffs. So, will quarterback Andrew Luck keep up his winning streak?
CNN's Rachel Nichols sat down with number 12 to talk about heroics and if he has what it takes to win tonight's big playoff game. Well, contrary to reports on the internet, people, Niagara Falls did not freeze solid during this week's polar vortex.
It did not, but it did ice over. Yeah. Good time to pull it out, make sure the batteries are fresh, and turn up the volume.
Yeah, there's a line of storms that's rolling across the eastern U.S., and tornadoes are possible before the day is done. CNN meteorologist Jennifer Gray is here with more. What have you learned, Jennifer?
Well, we've already seen tornado warnings this morning.
So thank you so much.
Right. Whitney Houston's daughter, Bobby Christina Brown, has tied the knot to longtime friend Nick Gordon.
Congratulations again. Hey, that's going to do it for us today, and we are so grateful to have had you watching.
And we've got a lot that we're covering in the next hour. Of course, the breaking news this morning, the death of former Israeli Prime Minister Ariel Sharon, mm-hmm, the water woes in West Virginia, those 9 counties who are dealing with the lack of water. But FEMA is coming in. They've already sent in, mm-hmm, the first truck. So let's toss it over now to Frederica Whitfield, who is watching all the big stories.
Very good. I know you guys have had a very, very